I'm Marcella Evaristi. Episode 1, Meet the Millers. Hey, Dad. No, she's still not here. You have to tell her.
I will, but hey, you know, there is no lateness on planet Lucy. It's a world with no clocks. Just mirrors. Many, many mirrors.
And a Katie in it.
Mirrors, Katie, and lip balm to protect those girls from the desert heat of Highgate. I miss you so much.
Do you?
Are you kidding? I'd have you here every single weekend again. That didn't really work out.
I know. It's all right. Don't worry.
I'm not worried. Mum and I are working on it. We'll sort it out before your gap year, I swear.
Good. Dad, you know the Georgian dot lunchboxes?
Yeah.
Do you think you can still see that it's me on them?
No. Well, less and less every day. Hardly at all. You still make you nervous, eh?
A bit.
Tell me.
It's fun, really.
Well, you know, it's great that you inspired Mum to invent the adventures of Georgie and Dot. I mean, that's fantastic. She just never thought through the merchandise thing.
The thing is, you never know how it's going to go.
Right.
When they see that it's my face on the side of the Georgie and Dot lunchbox, when they realise that's me, Georgie...
Yeah, that would make me nervous too, given what happened. But that little creepy bully juice history, eh? You survived him like a superhero.
Malcolm wasn't little.
I know, baby.
He jumped up and down on it, on the lunchbox, and then on my actual face.
Little bastard. Wasn't that bad a likeness.
Ha ha, very funny.
This won't last, you know? I mean, you're not going to look like Georgie for much longer. It won't be long before you have this fuzzy upper lip, and you'll be, you know, disfigured with acne and everything. I promise you, in about 5 minutes, you're going to be practically unrecognisable.
I'm going to be 10 next week. What do you mean, 5 minutes?
I just mean the time passes quickly.
Not when you're waiting for Lucy to come and collect you. You never told Mum, did you?
About being teased about the Georgie thing?
Yeah.
No, of course I didn't. You made me promise.
She just get, you know...
I know. Oh, I know how she gets.
Hey, hello, beautiful.
I'm sorry to disturb you. Lucy, grab my keys again. I need your set. Oh, you shouldn't be here, I know. You haven't finished the ending. You have industrial earmuffs on.
To block out the world. Apart from my girl. Keys are right here. But I love you for interrupting me.
It's very sexy having to withhold my lust all the time.
Well, for my generation, that wasn't as much fun as you think. Come here. You know, you look about 12 standing there with your lunchbox.
Ah, that 20 years age gap. Makes me feel so young. But you know, I still worry the kids are too recognisable from this picture on the side here. What do you think?
Your illustrations? No. They're far too stylized to be a problem. I love them. I love you.
Oh.
Mimi, I have no idea how to finish this play. This last act is killing me. I'd love you to read it, but there's not time for anything. Hey, where are you going?
Oh, I'm doing a reading at the bookshop round the corner. I used to work there part-time when I was writing my book on Samuel Beckett.
Ah, now there's an author that's hard to get the merchandise right for.
Oh, I don't know. Little Tramps, A Dolly in a Dustbin. Where's Godot, you know, as in where's Wally?
Jeez, I married a woman who can even popularize the absurd. And who made me want to get married again.
Oh no, oh God.
What's wrong?
Lucy's here.
That's good.
No, that's bad. Bye-bye.
What?
Don't come near me. I don't know you, okay?
How was your day, Mon Petit Omelette?
Take that off your head.
Come on then, do you want to carry some of my stuff? The weight of all this is making me walk very slowly.
Give it to me. Go on, I'll carry your stupid stuff if you just start walking fast. Please!
Okay, take my tuba then.
Ugh! Why have you got a rubber fish head on your head?
Isn't it great?
Take it off or else.
Or else what?
Or you'll be very sorry.
Because you'll do what?
I won't let you hide your energy drinks in my treehouse anymore. No more buzzy.
Why are you so cross? If someone's been mean, just say the word. What's wrong with you?
No one's been mean to me. I don't know anyone yet at this place. I've just been collected by a fish head girl. Why have you got that on?
I wish Miss Evans was here.
I wish she was too, instead of me.
No, I mean to explain it. She explained it so well. The strange world that is surrealism.
Don't slow down.
It's all like, you look in the mirror and what you see is the back of your own head.
The back of your own head has got great big green scales down it. Shame that, because I was hoping to make some pals here, you know?
Don't fret, Tomlet.
Hello, I'm new. Would you fancy a sleepover at mine? This is my sister, Fishface. Come home and meet the rest of the tank.
I want you to help me with my surreal images project tonight.
I'll do it. Whatever it is, I'll do it if you promise right now to take that thing off.
Deal. And listen, the second Mum tries to go off and find a book about the Surrealists, you just follow me upstairs quick, okay?
Okay. Funny how she does that. Anything at all you ever want to talk about, it's bingo! She's off to get a book.
Drives me bloody mental.
Nick more!
Lucy, why does Tom have a small model train stuffed halfway inside his mouth?
Nick more!
Oh, this is great. Tom, don't move. This is unbelievable. What a great shot.
Lucy!
Tom, keep holding up the carriage like your mouth is the tunnel. You open wide. Yeah, that's great.
Oh, no, that's enough. He's gagging.
And the train is chugging right into his little face in a world without logic. It is for my homework. We're being all helping each other out like Georgie and Dot. Hello.
Hello. Tom's not your slave.
Or bitch, either, tell her.
Lucy, your history essay about women's suffrage is due on Monday. It's on the table here, and I don't trust you to finish it at your dad's.
But this is homework I'm doing now for my surrealism project, and I'm loving it. What about that Salvador Dali and his wife, eh?
His wife?
His wife Marguerite. What a crazy pair.
Oh, just a minute. I've got a marvellous book about Miro and his contemporaries.
Bingo!
What's wrong with you two?
Nothing. Mom, Lucy met me at the school gate with a rubber fish head on and she was late.
Oh, Lucy, don't leave the boy hanging about.
Is that it?
Just imagine if Marguerite married Dali before he went and grew his big mad moustache. I would have divorced just for doing that.
Please don't ever divorce for shallow reasons. Marguerite is a man. Look, here's a photo of them all on a balcony in the 20s.
Yeah, fine.
You know, I took both my divorces very seriously. Now, here's the essay. You left it in...
I'll read it to you.
Lovely. Here, I've made scones. Tom, get the jam.
The suffrage movement in Edwardian England. Have you ever heard about the famous B-Day? Miss Evans showed us. It's probably in that book.
What?
You know, the famous D-Day that completely changed the face of modern art.
It was a urinal. Now start.
A urinal?
Yes, Tom, a urinal. It belonged to a chap called Duchamp.
Right. Oh, I'm quite lucky, really. I could have been collected by a fish that was carrying a urinal. I could have ended up carting it home along with a tuba.
Lucy, I want to see how far you've got with this. And then Dad can check it over when you're at Dominique's.
It's Dad and Dominique's. Oh, it is more her house, though, isn't it?
No, well...
It's got a totally her house feel to it. Mm.
But it's completely his house, too. She's a designer, and that's why her stamp is on it. Maybe more than his.
I don't think Dad stamped on it at all.
No, I meant... Oh, you two. He and Dominique are terrific together, and they're business partners, and they're happy, and it's just great. Harry and I were just saying that today.
Is Harry in the country, then?
Of course he is.
Oh, I thought he was abroad still.
No, he's just been holed up in his office stroke flat in Gospel Oak. Once he's finished the play he's writing, he'll have the time to properly move in here, hopefully before our first wedding anniversary.
So what's his play about, then?
It's about a painful marriage in a family where these children are manipulated and poisoned against one of the parents.
Yeah,
but it's a comedy, you know, to show there's no bitterness.
Can we go and see it?
Of course. It's going to be produced in London.
Cool.
You know, kids, not every divorced couple ends up like your dad and I, you know?
With all the remarrying?
With the remaining deeply fond of each other.
But Dominique and Jean-Claude are really good friends.
Not off. No, that's absolutely right, Tom. In fact, I think Dominique and Jean-Claude are even friendlier than Joe and I. I quite a big soupçon.
Dear Dominique, I can't do this anymore. No, that's too melodramatic. She'll think I'm talking about us, about the marriage and not the job. Delete. Dear Dominique, I am writing to resign from your company. I owe you so much. You are a wonderful stepmother to Lucy and Tom and an inspired visionary interior designer aesthete style blazer. I am bursting with pride as I sit here in our dining room. You in Paris and me perched on Jean-Claude's glass chairs. How is Jean-Claude? I sound a bit sarky.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.